Don't let somebody else's holler take your holler. You ought to have one of your own. While thinking about how good God's been, hallelujah just ought to begin to flow out of your mouth. Hallelujah. God the glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Thine the glory, revive. Hallelujah. The Bible says that the arms of the Lord are like the mountains around Jerusalem. Thank you, Jesus. What that means is that anything that does come in, it can't come in unless Jesus lets it in. Hallelujah. And anything that God exposes you to, he also gives you the power to overcome it. That's 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 13. There's nothing that we go through that God has not already prepared a way of escape. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Touch somebody and tell them, just look for the way. Hallelujah. Sometimes look like the enemy coming against you, and it seems like the only option is to turn back. But tell somebody, don't you turn back. Just look for the way. Because it's already been made. You just got to find the way. You don't really have much looking to do, because he said, I am the way. Hallelujah. When you find him, you have found the way. Hallelujah, God. Lord Jesus, this is for you. These are not hand claps of affirmation, but these are hand claps of thanksgiving. Thank you. You told us to clap our hands. And so tonight we offer you praise with the clap of our hands. Hallelujah. 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 Now, while you're clapping, just open your mouth and shout. This is not emotional. We just gonna obey God. He keeps on to say, shout unto God with the voice of triumph. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. See, when y'all start clapping and shouting at the same time, this makes the devil nervous. He came, but he got to go now, because he getting nervous. And when you saturate the room with this kind of praise, this is the praise of agreement. This is the praise of agreement. Let God arise and his enemies be scattered in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. You are worrying about things that can't prosper in the first place. You have left your mind fragmented in unresolved situations when he says in the book of John, my peace I give you. He said, I'm trying to give you mine, because that stuff you got ain't going to work. Talking to your friends about it ain't going to help. Going to happy hour ain't going to help. Having a joint for a break ain't going to help. Gossiping and running all the folk down to pull yourself up ain't gonna work. He said, let me give you something. I will give you peace that surpasses all. All you got to do is just keep your mind. That's Isaiah 26 and verse number 4. I will keep you in perfect peace. If you just meditate, think about me. See, because you can't think about God and think about evil at the same time. Watch this, y'all. Watch, and this will make you run. See, we ain't a running church no more, but this will make you run. God is so awesome. He's so intrusive. God help me. He's so intrusive. You can't think about him and think about garbage at the same time. You can't think about God and think about confusion at the same time. God got a takeover spirit. If you think about him for a minute, he'll take over the whole hour. If you think about him all one day, he'll take over the whole week. He just intrudes all over. Total praise. You are, oh, you are. God bless you. Jesus loves me, for the Bible tells me.
Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Oh, yes, hallelujah. Jesus loves me. For the Bible tells me so.
Some of us, our lives are wrecked because we're too sensitive. And we're responding to things that pull on us emotionally instead of responding to things principally. All I want to do is teach tonight so that we can be better.
When I go to God, it is suggested, real prayer. It is suggested when I go to God, it's because I'm pursuing Him.
Most of us, our prayer lives are dysfunctional because we use prayer only to get from God instead of trying to get to God. I said prayer is not to get from God. It's to get to God.
And see, I want you to know that God looks at us suspicious-like when we're always trying to get from Him, because it suggests, I just want what you have, but I don't want to be close to you. But if you just get Him, when you get Him, then not only do you have everything that He has, but you got Him too. See, and the thing is, what you're going to find out, here's the blessing, is when you get Him. Because when you got Him, you got His money, you got His protection, you got all of His resources. But then watch this. There are some things that money can't buy. So when I need some peace, money can't buy peace, but He got it. Oh yeah, when I need some understanding, money can't buy understanding. It can buy you information, but it can't buy you understanding. And that's why a lot of us have information and no understanding. We got money, but we still broke. We got medicine, but we still sick. Because we got from God, but we didn't get to Him. When you pray, you can go through stuff and stay put and be stable. Not have your mind waver and be tossed to and fro. Some of us shout too much to be so weak. See, my shouting ought to mean something. That's why when the dance would break out in the old church, it meant something. It meant I'm holding on. It didn't mean I was happy. It didn't mean dance then. It didn't mean I got a raise. It didn't mean I got another car. It didn't mean I got another house. The dance meant I'm holding on. I ain't letting go. That's what it meant. We just done changed the meaning. Woo, look at my new shoes. And there is no power in that. Prayer transforms passions. Prayer helps us to mature. Because the more I pray, if prayer is the highest form of the human spirit and it brings me in communion with God, then the more I talk to God, the more I learn more of His will for my life. And the more I learn about what He desires for my life, then what happens over time then, now my desire, now His desire becomes my desire. And His will becomes my will. I'm trying to help you here. The things that God loves become the thing that I love. The things that God sees, now I can see it. So now when I pray, I get an answer to my prayer because I'm no longer praying with wrong motives. But you can't know how to talk to Him until you know what His will is. Because when you pray to God without knowing His will, then you're going to always pray amiss. See, with faith, you can be what God has called you to be. And you ain't got to drive a certain kind of car. You ain't got to wear a certain kind of clothes. You ain't got to nurse certain people. See, sometimes faith don't make you go after it. Faith make you turn your back on it.